My name's Jeff Makarevich, and welcome to Wine and Dine with Jeff, where I'll make a healthy dinner from start to finish and pair it with wines from around the world. Let's fill up that glass. Hi, my name's Jeff Makarevich, and welcome to Wine and Dine with Jeff. Today, we're making this delicious Parmesan crusted cod that you'll have on the table in 20 minutes. It is delicious. And we're gonna be pairing it today with this white blend that from Paso that you will fall in love with. But let's get started here. We have some cod right here. First tip, you want to make sure and get all the moisture off of your fish. And if you don't have cod, so I'm using a paper towel right here just to take off all the moisture. If you don't have cod, there's many, many other ones you can do. Haddock, tilapia. I'm putting some salt and pepper on my fish right now. And flounder, sole, whatever you have in your area. It will just work perfect. So we got that done. This is so easy, this recipe. Now to that, in the bowl right here, I have a little bit of mayonnaise. And we're gonna put some Dijon mustard right on in with that mayonnaise. So let's get some Dijon, and all the exact measurements are right down below in the description center for you. Make it nice and easy. So let's stir this around. And that Dijon just gives it a little bit of tang. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna schmear, right? Isn't that a professional thing? A schmear. We're gonna schmear some of this delicious, delicious mayonnaise and Dijon blend right on each fish fillet, like so. You can do a light schmear, a heavier schmear, whatever you'd like. And what it does actually too, is it helps with moisture. So when you're baking the fish, this mayonnaise moisture keeps moisture in. It's like a little barrier just in case you happen to overcook the fish a little bit. It does wonders, I'm telling you. So we are done there. Let's get our crunchy topping going. I like using chives in this panko crust. It just brings this light little touch of beautiful color and some delicious, delicious onion flavor. If you don't have chives, the tops of green scallions would work also. Let's get our panko crusting going. Now, what I love about this, and I'm gonna zest a lemon right now. What I love about this recipe, I call it a pantry staple. You could have everything right in the refrigerator. The fish could be frozen, you know? It's up to you. I mean, I actually have some fresh cod, but if you had some frozen fish, and everything here is mostly a pantry staple, I can tell you that. It's everything that you already have in your cabinets. So some lemon zest going right on in like that. Save this lemon because you're going to squeeze some juice on it in the end. And we had some chives that we chopped up, remember? Let's throw our chives in. And we're just going to add a little bit of olive oil to the mix right now, about a tablespoon. And we're just going to add some salt. Now watch your salt level in here. Just a little bit of salt and some cracked black pepper. Because the Parmesan cheese that we're using has a lot of sodium in it already. So there we go. We got that all nice and mixed together. And I love the chives in this. I really do. And Parmesan cheese going right on in. And this is where there's only a few ingredients to this recipe, right? So this is where important things like the Parmesan cheese are extremely important. from a block, exactly like you see right here. This is 2 year aged Parmesan cheese. It is amazing. It tastes great. It really makes all the difference. So that is done. That is it with our crunchy topping. It's that simple. Let's put it all together. Now let's just put it all together. We got our cod here that already has our mayonnaise and beautiful. Just lay it down right in there. That's almost gonna act like glue. Bring it back out. Take a look at that. Is that amazing? Lay it right in a sheet pan that has buttered or olive oil or spray, whatever you'd like. And I actually like to put a little more on top because I like a big crunchy coating on it. So take this because you're gonna have leftovers, as you can see here, and make a nice thick coating crust on top. Now let me get the other one in the pan and I'll throw some vegetables in too. Now, important tip, you wanna have that oven waiting for you. It's at 425 degrees Fahrenheit, and the fish is only gonna go between 10, 12 minutes, maybe 15 minutes, depending on the thickness of the fish that you are using. If you have a super thick cod, it will go a little bit longer. Now, I'm throwing some root vegetables in here along with it, just to make it a meal. This is gonna be a whole meal. So I'm just throwing in some vegetables. I threw in some olive oil and just put some salt and pepper in. And once again, you just wanna make sure for your fish that it's flaky, it's moist, but that mayonnaise topping will definitely keep it nice and moist. And for your vegetables, you wanna have a vegetable that's gonna be able to take 425 degrees in the oven for a minimum of 10 minutes. So a root vegetable like these cut thin will work perfectly because I love my veggies all nice and crunchy right in the middle layer. We'll let that go for at 425 degrees. We'll check it in 10 minutes. Perfect time to talk about the wine while our fish is roasting in the oven. This is an amazing winery in Paso Robles, Tablas Creek. It is their Tablas White Blend, their Blanc, which is a Grenache Blanc, a Roussan, Marsan, a few others thrown in there that are really small percentages. Wow. Right off the bat, I'm getting like tropical notes with a little bit of honeysuckle and orange zest. Oh, this is fantastic. I'm getting like nectarine and mandarin orange in the taste. Wow, you are gonna love this one. I guarantee you it will go perfect with this fish. It's been 12 minutes and it smells amazing in this house. Oh yes. Okay. Look at that. Oh yes. Look at that sizzling. That is done perfectly. Vegetables are done. The fish is flaking apart. Let me plate that up. I can't wait to dig in. Before I taste, I would first like to thank all my subscribers. And if you're not yet a subscriber, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my recipes. And don't forget to like and share and ring that bell because that notifies you that I have a new recipe. And I have one every Tuesday, guaranteed. But I can't wait any longer. I'm putting my wine down. Let me dig into this. Oh yes, we want to squeeze a little bit of some of that lime juice right on that edge where I'm gonna be having a bite. Look how flaky and moist that is. Yes. So tasty and vibrant. You're gonna love it. Easy, delicious pantry staple here, this Parmesan crusted cod. Thanks for stopping by Wine and Dine with Jeff. And we'll see you next week.